Hey guys, it's Samantha Jade here. I have just released a new song called Always, and I am a new guest at Summer Bay on Home and Away. So I'm sure you have a few questions for me. So I'm here to answer them. I want to sing for you as well. And I also have invited one of my friends, so I've got a special guest too. Favorite song to perform live so far? Probably, I do love performing Shake That. I think that's a really fun one, and it's very like girl power on stage, and we have a lot of fun with it. So yeah, that one. Possibly, I don't know yet, but that is a good idea. Thank you. Maybe you've just given me a great idea. So we'll see. Pinch myself moment. I've had a few. I mean, winning an ARIA, my first year going to the ARIAs and being nominated and then winning, that was pretty amazing. That was an incredible moment. And probably years ago, like long time ago when I was signed in the States, when I was only 17, I did a showcase, and it was with Chris Brown back in the day. And we shared a showcase together, and then he went on to be Chris Brown and I got dropped. But, you know, picked myself back up again. But that was a pretty pinch yourself moment too. It's pretty amazing. My number one advice to make it in the industry. Hard work. You get nowhere in this industry without working hard and dedicating all your time to your craft. I think that's the main thing. I think you have to be, you know, the passion that we have for what we do is kind of, you know, endless. It's all we think about. We're always, you know, brainstorming ideas of how we can be better and how we can learn. I think you never stop learning, and if you know that, then you continue to work hard. And yeah, you don't really make it without hard work. And good people around you, not yes people, honest people. So good family and friends that will be honest with you and let you know when you're getting too big for your boots. Aw, thank you. Hello, US. I think, thinking out loud, when I heard that song, I was like, gosh, I wish that was my song. And Stay With Me, Sam Smith. Because they're both timeless songs. And I think for singers, you know, the timeless songs, the ones that are going to last throughout the years and also be wedding songs and, you know, graduation songs, those are the songs that you want to have written. Sometimes I do Google myself, yeah. Sometimes I do, because sometimes I never see the pictures that I take, so I Google them. Like, I try and find them on Google. So yes, guilty. my number one would be, you know, to be happily married with kids. That's, you know, definitely a very huge dream for me, just as important to me as music. And then, you know, to maybe be big in the UK and maybe have, you know, some songs out there that people know, and just to have big crowds singing my lyrics that I've written back to me. That's the dream. I would love to record a duet with Ed Sheeran. I just think that would be heaven. I just want him to write me a song. That would be the dream. And I'd love to sing a chorus on a Drake song. It'd be amazing. Call me. There's a lot coming up this year that I can't talk about. It's always like that. But some really exciting things outside of music and acting that are in the pipeline that I can't speak about. And I'm the ambassador for the Logie, so I'm really excited about that, because that's going to be a really great night. And a trip to London to do some songwriting. Oh, my style inspiration. I have a few. I love Victoria Beckham. I think she's very classy and very chic, so I really like her. I think Rachel Zoe is really cool, but I could never pull off what she wears. She's too cool for me. But I do love to stalk her. And Kylie Jenner, she's my new one. She's like the coolest girl ever. I want to dye my hair purple now, or blue, or whatever it is today. It was crazy. It was a big eye-opener, because I think that, you know, touring with the biggest boy band in the world is just, you know, it's larger than life. Everything was larger than life. The trailers were crazy. The food was incredible. There were girls literally everywhere. I think the craziest part was when we were in Melbourne, and they had somehow found out they were staying at Crown. And so we were there, and we walked in, and we were just going to actually have a drink after the show. And there were, the whole lobby was just girls everywhere, and they were just sitting there. Do you know anything? Do you know where they are? I was like, I don't know. I'm not here to see them. They're like, oh, they're here. They're just in that room. They knew everything. I just don't understand how you guys know all that stuff. That's amazing. You should be detectives. It's very impressive. Enjoyed it. That was such a fun song to write. I love that song. It was actually the last song we wrote for the record, and it was even more fun to shoot the video, who stars my friend who was supposed to be here, but I don't know where he's gone.
Always.
What is that? Wait a second. Nick!
Oh, hey!
Hi!
Hey.
There you are!
I don't know, I think I got here a bit early, but...
Hey, good to see you!
Yeah, you too.
This is for you.
Oh, that's for me? Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, do you want to hold it?
Yeah, what's happening?
Well, I'm just hanging in the Blue Room, Twitter Blue Room.
Oh, cool.
That's where we are.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Because I know you came through there, so it's a different
place. Yeah, right.
But we're just answering some questions. Do you want to answer some with me?
Yeah, sure.
Right, come sit.
Come on, I'm gonna just
come on. He makes an entrance, doesn't he? Come on in.
Yeah, cool.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nick Westaway.
Hi, guys.
Woohoo! All right, let's answer these questions. Oh, my favourite part is probably the whole glam side of it. You know, like you get to look your best because you get to get the best hair, best makeup.
Well, you did.
Yeah. Oh, you looked good too. Come on.
Oh, thank you.
You looked great.
Yeah, I tried. Yeah. I got to drive the fancy car too.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, what was your favourite part? The car.
Yeah, the car. Yeah.
The car, thanks.
No, you were fun too.
Okay, thanks. A second, but that's fine.
Watching you get really hot out in the desert. And
yeah, oh my gosh.
Shade, having a drink.
Yeah, so Nick, let me just paint this picture. So I'm out in the desert in an outfit with hair extensions and makeup and body bronzer. Boiling hot, and he's like sitting there with a shirt of having a water under a tent.
Wasn't bad. I braved the heat a little bit and got some behind the scenes.
You did actually, yeah.
I'll share.
Nice guy. Good guy. The best thing for me, you know, being guesty was just kind of, I guess, you know, when you grow up kind of seeing a show and watching a show and seeing all these places that you've seen on TV for years and then you're in them, that's a pretty pinch yourself moment. It's pretty cool. And I think the cast and the crew are really lovely. They're such a great crew. Everyone makes you feel really at home and really nice.
Yeah, it's kind of that energy that you have the people who have stuck around for a long period of time. In the cast and the crew, you've got like the veterans that are there and they just love it and they just keep it rolling. And then the people who are new that just come in, they just get taken under someone's wing and they just take off and run with it. So that's the way that I found how it kind of operates. And over the years that I've been there, I sort of have kind of made that transition and I see sort of guest roles, you know, looking to me for advice and tips and stuff. And I just, and I still feel like a newbie myself. But, you know, if I have any advice that I can give, I generally pass it on. And I still look to the veterans to help me out. Like Ray Maher, wow, he's heart and soul of that show. I don't get to do a lot of scenes with him, but, you know, just having a chat with him on set every now and then is just, it's so inspirational. He's just driven the show for over 30 years.
Yeah, and he's so nice.
So nice, so grounded, it's amazing.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, so the first day was intense. We can't say too much because it hasn't aired yet, the first actual day. But,
Because our first day of shooting wasn't the first episode. Appearance of Isla in the Bay.
Yeah.
Because we have so many casts and Home and Away runs so quickly, we have to shoot out of order sometimes. So sometimes it confuses us, but we try and keep up with it. And to a newbie on the show, it was a little bit tricky, but you just have to pick it up and run with it.
Go in there, yeah. Wait till you see it. Wow, it was intense. Favourite moment with Nick Westaway, who happens to be right here. How crazy, hey. On Home and Away, what was it? Probably like our first day of shooting together. They just threw us right in, and it's the scene that you're going to see tomorrow night, maybe?
I think
it's tomorrow night, so I can't say too much about it, but it was pretty crazy, and we pretty much were not on a closed set. We were open place, and we were doing some crazy stuff, and that was our first day, and Nick really helped me out, because I was really nervous.
Yeah.
What was your favourite?
I don't know, it was a bit of that, throwing you in the deep end was kind of fun for me, because it kind of happened to me as well. Like, when I first joined the show, it was a similar thing as they put me right in the deep end. I went to South Australia, as a lot of you would remember, kidnapping my half-brother and, you know, taking him off to the desert and stuff like that. So it got very intense very early on. And, it sort of reminded me about me starting when you kind of joined in.
Passing the baton.
Yeah, I was kind of happy that I could kind of help you along the way. But, you know, you're fine. Sink or swim. You just dove in.
Yeah, get in there. WA people, that's how we do it. Well, the hardest part for me was kind of figuring out what, like, okay, so tomorrow I'm shooting this, because they give you these scripts, and it is so nerve-wracking. I was like, what am I reading? Because you have to kind of work it out yourself. I think that was the hardest part.
Yeah, I'd say being out of order would have been a bit tricky. Yeah. It's tricky for people to pick that up.
Yeah.
A lot of us have actually gone off paper, save the trees, and invested in iPads.
Yeah, you're good.
And so putting the scripts in an iPad makes it easier for you to keep track of what scene has been shot or hasn't been shot, or just chronologically in the story, what has already happened, what hasn't happened yet.
Mm.
And so that kind of works it out. I think the hardest thing for me, though, is the schedule. You know, you have some days when you're only needed for a couple of hours, but then you'll have the big, like, 16-hour days, like you would have remembered. One of the first days when we go out on location and lots of energy needs to be used and everything else. And one of those really tough days and you get home. At least you sleep really well those days.
Yeah, that is actually very true. Yeah. You sleep very well when you shoot Home and Away.
Yeah, but it's just not, it's not regular 9-to-5 work at all.
And even the days where it's like 9 to 12, then go home for 4 hours, then come back.
Big breaks.
That's kind of weird. I was closest to this one.
Literally, figuratively?
Both. No, but we actually had pretty much every scene together.
Yeah, basically.
If I wasn't in a scene with Nick, I'm kind of by myself, really.
Yeah, I think there were times when they forced us to be apart.
Yeah, we just didn't want to.
We didn't.
You know, just we needed to be together.
When you went somewhere else, I kind of followed you.
Yeah,
and vice versa. And then, yeah, just, was it even in the script that that happened?
No, or did we, I just think my we just did that. Wasn't. That was just weird. Yeah, just... Oh my goodness. Well, now that Nick's the last love interest from my music video, he gets to audition all the newbies.
Yeah.
So you're going to have to go through him to get to me.
Yeah. And I was in your last music video, so you don't have to go to the gym that much.
Oh, that's not true. You do have to go to the gym. No, I'm kidding. Oh, gosh. Be a nice person. I like nice people. Yeah.
Full stop. Is that it?
I like nice
That sounds really
people.
Easy.
I know. There's a lot of nice people out there. Be nice, be funny, and be humble. Yeah.
Yeah, and but, yeah.
That taller than me, which is really easy. So you're a shoo in there. I think that's about it. Quite an easy person. What do you think?
Oh, for me, for a guy or a girl? What do you mean?
No, for a guy. Like, if you had to audition them, my friend.
Oh, to be, yeah.
To, yeah, what on your you behalf. Yeah, on my behalf.
yeah, just that sense of ease with themselves, I think.
Yeah.
I like people with that energy that they're okay being who they are, you know, and they
confidence.
Yeah, they're surrounded with people that get along with the same amount of people. Like I saw a quote the other day, which I thought was really funny, which was something about if you find people with the same sort of quirks as you, then keep them round because those people are your tribe.
I like that.
I kind of like that.
Join my tribe.
So, like, other people, if you don't get along with them, it doesn't mean that you have to not like them or they don't like you or anything else. It's just that you have different paths in life. So you find the people that do have the same sort of values. So.
And then you'll be on the same path.
Yeah.
So words of wisdom from Nick Westaway.
Yeah, there you go. Brilliant. Got a bit deep there for it, didn't it?
Well, you're an actor.
People who like themselves as themselves. There you
yes,
go.
That's agreed.
Just to summarise.
I'm not sure if I'll be performing. I hope so, but I'm not sure. I know that Nick is doing a song or two.
Oh, no.
No?
I hope that you are. And I may do backup dancing if you perform. You know,
I was maybe hoping you'd do
something. If I have the time to rehearse, possibly.
Yeah, well, I can arrange that.
Maybe get on a guitar. I'd have to enter character, and then, because Kyle's a better guitar player than me.
Is he?
So,
yeah. Oh, well, Isla can't sing, so that would be messy.
We'll work something out. Isla can't sing? Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
Would that be weird? That'd be weird if Kyle meets Sam.
Yeah.
Oh, that's weird.
She'd be a lot nicer than I would say that much.
But I hope you're performing.
Thank you. Me too. Thanks, Shelley. I don't know how you would have heard that, but yes, Nick Issa is a great little singer, and he plays.
Oh.
And I saw your profile, and you need to get a picture, because you haven't even hatched yet. You're still an egg. But this is... What do you want to sing? I'll just harmonise with you.
What about that bit from the Ed Sheeran song? That was singing before.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Go for
and
it.
They say she's in the class 18, stuck in her daydream. Been this way since 18, but lately her face seems slowly sinking, wasting, crumbling like pastries, and they scream, the worst things in life come free to us, cause we're just under the upper hand. Go mad for a couple grand. We don't wanna go outside tonight. Oh, we actually do, so we should probably
stop. Yeah, let's go outside. Thank you guys so much for having us here at the Blue Room, and I hope you liked the acoustic performances, and I hope you loved my special guest. Who doesn't?
And I enjoyed the acoustic performances.
Oh,
they were great.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
Of course.
For letting me join in.
Anytime.
Beautiful. I thought
come
you answered
back.
All questions beautifully.
Oh, thank you. Yeah.
And I did my best.
You did really well. Oh, and I loved the secret entrance. That was cool.
That was good.
That was shocking.
I think I slept here. And just waited for you to get here today.
Yeah.
And just like, I've got your song on repeat. I've got your sing. I've got Always on repeat. Just
always.
Always on repeat. Always.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yep. Yeah. Okay, did that. I'm not going to repeat that. Thank you, guys. And I will see you next time. Mwah. Hey, guys. It's Sammy here. I'm going to do a cover of my favourite Sam Smith song, Not the Only One. My older songs called Firestarter. Take it away, Marcus.